Beyond the stark quiet of the execution chamber, beneath the controlled sterility of the procedure, lies a hidden and harrowing sequence of biological events. When the process of lethal injection begins, it sets off a cascade of reactions within the human body, each more profound than the last. To truly understand what happens, we must journey inside the body itself, tracing the path of each drug as it moves through veins, organs, and cells, bringing life's processes to an irreversible halt. It begins with preparation. The individual enters the execution room and is positioned carefully on a padded gurney. The weight of the moment hangs heavy. A team of technicians, trained for precision, locates suitable veins, often in the arms or hands. They cleanse the skin, insert intravenous lines, and secure them in place. These lines are the conduits for what is to come, delivering the lethal sequence directly into the bloodstream. The room is silent, clinical, and methodical. Every step is designed to ensure the drugs act swiftly and predictably. The first phase of the process is sedation, achieved with a powerful barbiturate, usually pentobarbital. As the plunger is depressed, the drug races through the IV tubing, entering the bloodstream. Within seconds, pentobarbital circulates throughout the body, passing through the heart and into the brain. It binds to GABA receptors on neurons, amplifying the effect of GABA, a neurotransmitter that calms neural activity. The result is a rapid, profound depression of the central nervous system. As pentobarbital takes hold, the person feels an overwhelming drowsiness. Their eyelids grow heavy, mental clarity dissolves, sensations of anxiety and fear recede, replaced by a wave of sedation. Conscious thought drifts away. Breathing slows and becomes shallow as the brain's respiratory centers are suppressed. Though the individual appears calm and unaware, the brain is still active, registering some final flickers of existence as neural activity fades. The next drug administered is pancuronium bromide, a neuromuscular blocking agent. Unlike the sedative, this compound targets the connections between nerves and muscles. It acts at the neuromuscular junction by blocking acetylcholine, an essential messenger that signals muscles to contract. The effect is total paralysis. Within moments, the muscles of the face become slack. The chest and abdomen cease their rhythmic rise and fall. The person can no longer move, speak, or even blink. Most critically, the diaphragm, the primary muscle responsible for breathing, is paralyzed. The lungs fall silent. Oxygen, once drawn into the body with every breath, can no longer reach the bloodstream. Carbon dioxide begins to accumulate. The heart continues to beat for now, but the body is already deprived of its most vital fuel. The final drug is potassium chloride, a chemical with the power to stop the heart within seconds. Normally, the heart's electrical activity depends on a delicate balance of sodium and potassium ions flowing in and out of cardiac cells. This orchestrated movement generates the electrical impulses that keep the heart pumping in a steady rhythm. When potassium chloride is injected, it overwhelms the system. Potassium floods the heart muscle, disrupting the electrical gradients that coordinate contraction. The heart's rhythm becomes erratic, first fluttering in a chaotic arrhythmia, then ceasing altogether. The last heartbeat marks the end of circulation. Blood, now motionless, no longer delivers oxygen to the tissues. Every organ, every cell is cut off from the sustenance it needs. In the brain, the consequences are immediate and catastrophic. Neurons, the most oxygen-hungry cells in the body, begin to die within moments of oxygen deprivation. As oxygen levels plummet, energy production ceases. neurons misfire and malfunction, losing their ability to communicate. Consciousness, already dimmed by sedatives, vanishes entirely. The brainstem, the body's command center for breathing and heartbeat, shuts down. Within a few minutes, irreversible brain damage occurs. Meanwhile, the rest of the body is succumbing to the lack of circulation. The liver, deprived of blood, can no longer filter toxins. The kidneys stop purifying fluids. Digestive organs stall. Muscles, already paralyzed, begin to break down. Cells rupture as metabolic waste builds up and tissues become starved of nutrients. This systemic shutdown is silent, relentless, and complete. From the moment the first drug enters the bloodstream to the point of total biological death, the process typically takes between 7 and 10 minutes. Outwardly, the scene appears calm, an unmoving body on a gurney, no visible struggle, but beneath this stillness, the body is undergoing a carefully orchestrated collapse, each organ system shutting down in turn. Yet, despite the clinical precision, the process is fraught with complexity and risk. The effectiveness of lethal injection depends on perfect administration, the right drugs, the correct dosages, properly placed IV lines. Errors can and do occur. If the sedative is underdosed or the IV line fails, the individual may remain conscious as paralysis and cardiac arrest set in, unable to move, unable to speak, but fully aware. Such scenarios have led to immense suffering and have fueled ongoing debates about the method's humanity. Medical experts and ethicists continue to question the use of lethal injection. Some argue that it was developed to be a more humane alternative to previous methods of execution, designed to minimize pain and suffering. Others point to the risks of botched administrations, the lack of medical oversight, and the ethical dilemmas for healthcare professionals asked to participate in executions. Globally, the complexities and controversies of lethal injection have led many countries to reconsider or abolish its use entirely. Beneath the surface, lethal injection is not simply a quick or painless end. It is a process that reveals the fragility of human life and the intricate vulnerability of our biological systems. From the first sedative-induced haze to the absolute stillness of biological death, each moment is governed by the interplay of chemistry, physiology, and irreversible consequence. This is the unseen reality of lethal injection, a sequence of events that, while outwardly calm, is marked by the complex, unforgiving shutdown of the body's most vital systems. Understanding this process brings into focus not just the mechanics of death, but the profound ethical questions that surround its use. In the end, it is a reminder of the delicate balance between life and death, and of the scientific, medical, and moral challenges inherent in acts of finality.